Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials on any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then please write me at contact@devopsschool.com. Thank you.
Can you show the header.compound.html? Surendra, just a second, I'll show. Surendra, have a look over here. Surendra, here, right, through this, right, we applied a click event, okay? This, are you done with this or not? Please let me know.
Can I?
Okay, so now the next point. Everyone, is it working at your end? Please confirm. If anyone is facing the problem, right, please let me know. I'll sort it out. Then I'll move to the next. So I'll consider this one is working at everyone's end, okay? Now, the next point. Are we done with this part? Okay, now, can we start this work now? Okay. One more thing. People, this part is working, right? Will this part is working or not for that purpose, right? Have you written the code inside the app.component.ts, correct? People, did you get my point or not? For this stuff, correct? Have we written the stuff inside the app.component.ts or not?
Yeah.
This one, correct? This one is also completed. So have a look over here. Now people, you're right. When we were working with the auth service, correct? Here, if you'll observe, have we set this header options or not? So for each and every for each and every interaction with my REST API, do you need to set this flag or not? People, is it possible for us to set this thing every time? This is a generic requirement. We are getting it correct. So instead of providing it, now think about people. We worked with the auth module, correct? If you are going to work with some other modules also, right? So at that time, will it create a, every time we have to provide this thing, correct? Now we want to handle this stuff. We want to handle this stuff in a very generic way, correct? So now the question is how to handle this stuff in a generic way. Right?
So Abhi, maybe we'll create HTTP service and then call that function here, something like that.
Yes, Prithvi, we are going to do in that way only. So that concept is referred as, Prithvi, that concept is referred as interceptor. Hello.
Okay.
Yes, that concept is referred as interceptor. Now have a look over here. So for that, right, we have to fire this command, ng generate interceptor. Now people, this setting the header option, right, is it a generic requirement or it's a specific requirement? People, it's a generic requirement, right? So now tell me, in which module should I create this interceptor?
Core module.
Core only, right? Why we'll prefer the core? Because core module is mainly used across the applications or not? Core module is mainly used across the application, correct? So from that perspective, right, here what I'll do, here I'll specify core slash interceptor slash header options. Clear, everyone? Okay. So this command, what I'll do here, let me break this current execution. What is that? It will take a minute. Okay, so here we will, have you observed the interceptors are created, right? If we'll go to the interceptors, right, now have a look over here. Here this interceptor is generated or not? here, right? This interceptor is generated, correct? Now, people, could you please do the same thing at your end so that we can proceed?
Could you move up the terminal a bit? Yeah, thanks.
You want to see the command, right? You can see this command now.
Abhi, what is the difference between service and interceptor?
I'll come for that. Give me a couple of minutes. Okay. I'm just getting people to create it, okay? I've not discussed it. Just I talked about how to create it.
Okay, sure.
And I just put a situation, okay?
Okay, sure.
Yeah, done.
Hello.
Abhi, I am unable to install interceptor. It says something like.
Yes, Prithvi, what is happening? I didn't get your point.
Yeah, when I try to generate interceptor, it says like interceptor not found in collection schematics angular.
Schematics, okay. Prithvi, could you please press the command what you fired? I think there's a spelling mistake. The schematic errors, right, will come. And which version you're using, Prithvi?
Angular, you're asking about Visual Studio Code or?
No, no, no. Angular version, Angular CLI version. 8 okay,
yeah,
fine. Do one thing, could you please press the command which you fired?
Yeah, this is the one I
yes, I got the point. See, this interceptor creation, right, is available, it's not available in a 8. Okay, you have to use the higher version.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Yes. Did you get the point?
Yeah. But do you want me to upgrade now? I don't.
No, don't go for that. Don't go for that. Instead of that, can you do one thing? At least, can you create the file?
Sure, I'll create it.
You create the file. I'll send you the stuff via notepad.pw. Is it fine?
Yes.
Prithvi, hello.
Yeah.
Prithvi, can you check the notepad? Prithvi, can you? You will get it over there. Did you get it?
Okay. Sure. I'll take it. Yes. Yeah, I took it.
Okay. Okay, people, now can we start the work? Okay, now people, listen to me very carefully. Most of you worked in Java, right? So in Java, right, people, have you worked with the in Spring or Hibernate also, right? You will did you come across with the interceptors? Or if you worked in a servlet JSP environment also, right? So there you can have a, there you will have a concept of filters, right? The same thing, the same kind of thing is done by the interceptor. Clear, everyone? The same kind of work is done by the interceptors. Now, others who are not from the Java background, for them, when you send any request from your Angular application to the REST application, any manipulation you want to perform it in a request or a response, so that work we can do it inside the interceptor. Clear, everyone? Yes or no? Well, I talk from the two perspective. If you are from the Java background, I've given that clarity. If you're not from the Java background, right? So that clarity also I have given it. So when it will come, whenever any request is going, every request will be passed through this interceptor. For example, again, I'll give one non-technical example, okay? People, when you'll access anything, if you want to access, for example, let's say abc.com in your FMR environment, right? There, will it go through several cross-checks under the firewall or not? All of you agree with this? For example, let's say if you want to access some abc.com, right? So for this abc.com, right, internally what will happen when you will raise the request from your browser, will it go through the fidelity firewall or not?
Yes.
And there it will have several cross-check points, correct? And based on that, it will give you the, either it will give you the no, it will give the access, or it will give you can't access. All of you agree with this? So whatever the firewall is doing the work, right? So the same kind of work is done by your interceptor. Now, people, I think everyone understood this point. Okay, next. Now, in this case, right here, manipulating the interest, adding the header option flags, that is not the only work that we can do it, but also you can handling how to handle the errors. Okay, then you can manipulate the some HTTP contents also. Okay, so all these kind of things, whenever whatever the request and response manipulation work you want to do it, right, all these kind of works we can do it via interceptors. Okay. Even though people, if you want to calculate the how much time a particular request took, okay, even that calculation also, right, you can do it. I think yesterday someone was asking, you want to monitor, right? You want to monitor the requests, correct? Which you are sending it from the Angular application. I think, Prithvi, are you there? You were asking this point.
Correct.
That kind of work, right? That kind of work, you can either you can use the log generations, correct? Or any kind of manipulations you want to do it, right? In that case, you can go ahead with the, you can go ahead with the interceptors. Clear, everyone? Okay.
Okay.
Now, people here, right? I will say, ideally, I need to deal with three interceptors. I need to create three interceptors, okay? But because of time, I will take, we will create only one, and for other two interceptors, I will share the code. Is it fine, everyone? Well, apparently I'm talking to you. I don't want to lie with you, okay? Because of the time, right? I need to actually, I want to cover three interceptors, but I will explain three, but I will not give you time for writing all the stuff. Is it fine, everyone? I will give you time only for one. Is it okay?
Yeah, okay. Babe.
I will explain word by word, everything I will explain, okay? But I will not give time for typing the stuff. I'll give this space only for one, not for two.
Got it.
Okay. Because people try to understand, we are working in a completely project-based environment. We, you know, it will take time, right? So because of that reason, I'm requesting you, nothing else. Fine. Okay. Chalo. Now the next point. Now people have a look over here. Here I'm going to create a file called index.ts. People, this file you have to create manually. All of you getting my point? This index.ts, this index.ts, you have to create manually. Everyone, have you created? Then please let me know. Okay, next. Now, why should I create this index.ts file? The reason behind this index.ts file is, the reason behind this index.ts file is, people tell me we can create n number of interceptors, right? Another point, we can create n number of interceptors, first point. Second point is, these n number of interceptors, these n number of interceptors, we have to utilize it. We have to utilize it. Did you get my point or not? Whatever the n number of interceptors that we'll create it, we want to utilize them. We want to utilize them across the application. Now, if you want to utilize these interceptors across the application, that means in each and every module, we have to register them. In each and every module, we have to register them. Now we will think about it. If I have 10 interceptors and if I have 50 modules, so this 10 interceptor ka entry, we have to do it 50 times or not? How much efforts we have to put it? Think about it. And later, if any kind of ease of maintenance is going to happen, will it create a trouble or not? people, for the understanding purpose, I'm saying 50 modules, okay. But you know in your projects how much efforts that you have to put in. Better than me, you know it very well, correct? Now think about age of maintenance over here. So to improve the age of maintenance, here what we'll do, here I'll declare an array of these interceptors, and people, instead of defining, now the which thing is convenient to you, please let me know. Instead of defining 10 interceptors at 50 places, this one is convenient to you, or whatever the 10 interceptors are there, I will define it into that array, and that array name, can I use it into those 50 or not? People, which situation is convenient to you? Situation one or situation two?
Using an array.
Second. The second, or using array, right, will be convenient for us, correct? Right now, here what we'll do. Now for that purpose, here I will specify the array details. Now for that purpose, here I will use export. Constant HTTP interceptor provider is equal to clear everyone. Okay, now inside this right here, I'll provide. Provide HTTP interceptor, comma, use class. Use class is nothing but the people. Have we implemented this HTTP interceptor interface or not? Correct. So here, what are we doing? Here we are going to provide the implementation class name, correct or not? Header options interceptor, correct? Comma. Multi, true. Is it giving us support for the multi modules? Yes, we are putting yes for the same. Now this is the registration that we have done it. Now people think about it. Now this array, what I'll do, I'll put it into my.
To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the 399 plan and grow your skills immensely.
Provider specification. That's it. Now in the same way, I have to register this one. I have to register this one into each and every module. We have to register them into each and every module under the providers. Now we'll think about it. If you are going to just copy paste the names also, right, we'll close it at one place, but later with respect to age of maintenance, will it create a trouble or not? Got it, everyone? In this way, inside the providers of every module, we will register them. Is it clear or not? People, I'll give you a couple of minutes. Can you do it?
Could you paste the code from index.tsrb?
Yes, Vignesh. Just a second, Vignesh. I'll do that. Sure. Vignesh, there may be a change in a name. Huh? You have to check what was the name that you have used it. Clear?
Sure. Yeah.
The same stuff I have provided, okay?
Okay.
Hello, we're done. People, are you done with this or not? Please let me know.
Yes, Abhi.
Okay.
Abhi, this providers which we have to include. So we have to include in all other modules, right?
Yes, in every module.
Dashboard. Shilpa. Okay.
Dashboard, admin, users. After this, in future also, whatever the modules that you will create, right? In every module, you have to include this interceptor. This
even in submodules.
Interceptor provider. Clear?
Even in submodules.
Yes, Shilpa. In every module, okay. I said. Got the point? Because
yeah,
it should, you know, to avoid the problems, right? As per this, mm-hmm. one of the standard practice will follow. Okay. So wherever you are coming across with any HTTP interceptors, right? So better provide that array everywhere. Clear?
Okay, thanks.
Yes, done everyone.
Yes.
People, if I'll take a call, can we, if I'll be on a mute for a couple of minutes, is it fine? I want to take a call, a bit urgent.
Sure.
Hello. Yes, people, I'm back. Now have a look over here. So here, right here. Now what we need to do. Here, right. We registered this one, correct? Now we'll go to this. We'll go to this interceptor. Now inside this interceptor, right, we have to write our story. So we have to write the story. So for that purpose, people, listen to me very carefully. Here, simple first, what I'll do, I will not take any headache. I'll just perform CLG. Hello from interceptor. Hello from interceptor. Just simply have mentioned it, correct? Now I'm going to start my application. Now people have a look over here. People, when this HTTP interceptor will come into the picture, when you're going to perform some, when you will perform some HTTP related activity or not. Now you are we getting this hello from interceptor? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right. So it's confirmed now. It is confirmed that here our interceptor is working. Correct, everyone? Here we have a confirmation, right? Interceptor is working pretty fine. People, could you please check the same thing at your end and then let me know? Okay, so people, if you'll observe, right here, what I have done here, just simply I have created the simple sysout message. Correct. Now instead of this, right, what we are expecting here, we are expecting that constant. Constant request equal to what is the current request that we are getting it over that current request, right? Over that current request here, I'm going to use a clone. Now what this clone will do, it will create a clone of this current object. Agree, everyone? And in this, right, I'm going to set the headers colon, and here I will provide content hyphen type application slash JSON. And here, instead of providing request, right, I'll provide req. This is one thing, correct? Now what I'll do here, we'll go to the auth service. Now inside this auth service, right, people, here we provided the header options, right? I'll remove it. I'll remove this and I'll save it. Now people, tell me, am I providing that content type as application slash JSON? Now am I providing? No, I'm not providing it anywhere. Correct, everyone? I'm not providing this part anywhere now. So if I'll delete this also, right, instead of deleting, just a second, I'll comment it so that when I'll share the stuff with you, so that it will be handy for you, right? Now let's do one thing. Now let's switch to the UI. Just refresh it. I'll delete this stuff now. Okay, and I'll erase this. People, if you observe in a network, right, in a network, where is this login? For this login, request header. Huh. People, in request header, right, are you able to see this content type as application slash JSON? Correct, everyone, or not? People, did you get my point or not? People, have we removed content type application slash JSON from our code, correct? And have we set it into the interceptor, right? Now, is it coming into the header directly or not? Prithvi, correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Correct. So now people tell me, in this case, instead of providing this application slash JSON content type in for each and every request, what I did, I set it into interceptor or not. So this interceptor, every time it will take care or not. All of you clear with this expectation or not? Jyoti, Balaji, Harsh, Gajalakshmi. Vignesh, Vithya. Okay. Now, next point. So people, this code, can I share it with you? Okay, I've shared it. You can take it from the notepad.pw. Okay. Okay, all of you taken, good to go.
Abhi, can you please show auth service.ts once?
Auth service.ts, yeah. So the last argument, right, Shilpa? The last argument was header options, correct? This header options, right? Shilpa, have you removed or not?
Okay. Okay.
Okay, done everyone, good to go. Okay, next point. Okay, now people have a look over here. ng generate interceptor logging. Core slash interceptor slash logging. Now we'll have a look over here. Okay, now people have a look over here. This logging interceptor is generated, correct? Now people tell me, do I need to register this logging interceptor everywhere? I will not do that. So what I'll do, simply I will just register this one into my index dot TS only. Clear everyone? All of you, clear with this or not? People, did you get the understanding why have we created this array? So if we'll register into this index, right? And this index.ts, is it, or this array, is it used everywhere or not? people, did you get the point or not? In this way, right, are we trying to achieve ease of maintenance or not?
True.
Clear? Okay, next point. Right, now inside this logging part, right, what I'm expecting. People, for this part, right, for this part, I'm going to bring a ready-made code. Is it fine to you? People, because of time, right, I'm bringing a ready-made code, okay? Actually, I don't like it, but because of the time constraint, right, I'm doing this thing, okay? Now, we will have a look over here. Prithvi, you asked yesterday, right? You want to take some traces kind of things, correct?
Yes, sir. Yes.
HTTP part, correct? So this tap method and the finalize method will be helpful for you. Finalize method will come into the picture irrespective of your exceptional situation or irrespective of your error, okay? And tap method is nothing but you can consider as good as whatever the task that you want to do it, right? So for example, let's say while handling this request, right, along with that, if you want to perform any work, so in that case we'll use pipe method. And inside this pipe method, right, whatever the task you want to do it for the particular request, so we'll write that stuff inside the request. Now in this case, right, if we'll observe the stuff, correct, here what I have done, whatever the response I'm getting, it right, am I printing this response or not? And inside the finalize, am I taking the time consumption by the request or not? Correct, everyone? Here, am I calculating time consumption by the request, correct? Yes or no? Now, I will look over here. People, know console part is a bit important. See, 160 milliseconds, it's a time which is consumed by my request or not. Sending the request and receiving the response. Correct, everyone? In that way, whatever the work that you want to do it regarding the request part, right? Can you do it inside the interceptor? Yes or no? Clear? Right. So, Prithvi, this one was your one of the constraint, right? You want to confirm, right? How much time it's going to take it, right?
Right. Yes,
so,
yes,
this is the stuff that you can use it. Okay. Fine.
Fine.
Yeah. So people, this is the stuff for the interceptor. Now, okay, I'll do one thing. People, I'll share this stuff with you on a Notepad PW. Could you please take it and could you please execute the same at your end? And can you confirm the outcome? Okay, done, everyone. People, good to go. Is it working at your end? Please let me know.
Yes, it's working.
Okay. So in this way, right, people, you can utilize the HTTP interceptor only for HTTP interaction. People, don't try to utilize it for some other purpose. If any request which is going out of your application, right, via request, then it will come into the picture. Otherwise, it will not. Got it, everyone? Okay, next point. Now, here, people, we have to work with sum okay okay now people have a look over here. Now let's start the discussion for the next concept called directives. Okay, this directives, pipes, right? These are very small concepts. Okay, these concepts we'll discuss. Okay, and at the end we'll have a quick discussion for Java 8 new features. Clear, everyone? So in this case, right here, let me start the stuff. Well, this is the major stuff that we have covered. Okay, whatever we covered, right, that was a major stuff. Fine. Now okay, people, this site, is it accessible to you? Stackbliss.com at your end. Could you please confirm?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then, people, other small parts, right? Instead of creating, see, I don't want to spoil this structure which we have created, okay? So this other parts, whatever I want to take it, right? If I'll take it into this Stackbliss application, is it fine? Otherwise, leave it. Otherwise, what we'll do? We'll do it here only. Okay. Now, here, let's start working for the concept called pipe. Now, for the pipe concept, right? Just a second. Let me open. People here, which year you are able to see? 2018, correct? Now what is the current year?
Please enroll our general membership for $3.99 plan to get access of all the parts.
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the $3.99 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.